Wenceslas looked out on the feast of seamen, when the snow lay round about, deep and crisp and even. Brightly shone the moon that night, though the frost was cruel, when a poor man came in sight, gathering winter fuel. Hither, page, and stand by me, if thou knowest telling, yonder peasant, who is he, where and what is dwelling?
Sir, he lives a goodly hence, underneath the mountain, right against the forest fence, by St. Agnes Mountain. Silent night is darker now, and the wind blows stronger, fills my heart, I know not how, I can go no longer.
Mark my footsteps, good my page, tread thou in them boldly. Thou shalt find the winter's rage freeze thy blood less coldly. In his master's steps he trod, where the snow lay tinted. It was in the very sod which the saint had printed. Therefore, Christian men, be sure, wealth or rank possessing, ye who now will bless the poor shall yourselves find blessing. Deck the halls with boughs of holly, fa-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la. Tis the season to be jolly, fa-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la. Dawning our gay apparel, fa-la-la-la-la-la-la-la. Drone the ancient yuletide carol, fa-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la. See the blazing yule before us, fa-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la. Strike the harp and join the chorus, fa-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la. Follow me in merry measure, fa-la-la-la-la-la-la-la. While we sing of yuletide treasure, fa-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la.
Merry Christmas.
Our thanks to the company for providing us some Christmas caroling tonight and getting us in the spirit. Yeah, give them a nice round of applause, you bet. All right. Well, welcome to the Parade of Lights tonight here at Archbold, Ohio. It's the 16th annual Parade of Lights here. My name's Bill Priest, and I'm looking forward to announcing the parade tonight. TV 26, you'll be able to see this throughout the Christmas season on that. Julie Brink is with me from the Archbold Area Chamber of Commerce. Julie, we've got a nice clear night tonight.
It is beautiful outside, and we had our Light the Night run. It was a great night for exercise. And
this is the first time you've done that.
That's right, and I want to thank all of you out there who participated, because it was a great first time.
I love seeing all the runners coming across here. Where did you get the blinky light? That's so cool.
Yeah. Well, we knew that people didn't want to wear T-shirts. And so we were trying to think of something else to give that would be appropriate for the evening, and we ran across these, and they're perfect.
Good call. All right. Well, Julie, the Parade of Lights is about to take place. They've already taken off now, haven't they?
They have, so they should be here in about 10 minutes, I'm thinking.
Okay. All right. They left ConAgra, so they're on their way up this way, and we'll be taking a look at this, and we'll be watching. We never know what the units are going to do to decorate for a new year.
Right, and some of the ones that are in every year even change things up. So I guess we'll just be surprised.
We'll look forward to it. I always look forward to see what creativity they apply and do for that. And, of course, one of the things that this Parade of Lights does is it leads to the Festival of Lights that you have in the park.
Right, and the Festival of Lights, actually, this is the 26th year for the festival. And so the festival will be lit tonight through January 1st. It is free, and you'll want to go through a couple of times. First time going right outside around the perimeter, and then the second time left, or whatever the case may be, because we've got displays all around the perimeter of the park, including inside.
So just don't go through Ruley Park. Make sure when you get to the end of the park to turn one way or the other and drive around on the outside, because you put displays all the way around.
Right, and this year we have a new display. It's Golfing Santa. And it was donated to the Festival of Lights by the Elias Fry family. My mouth is frozen, by the way. My mouth is not working right. The Elias Fry family commemorating his 100th birthday, what would have been his 100th birthday.
Oh, how neat. So we've got a golfing Santa this year, something new to see for the Festival of Lights. Now, do the kids get to meet Santa tonight?
They do. After the parade, we hope all the kids will head over to the pavilion where they'll get a complimentary picture with Santa, get to tell Santa what they want for Christmas, and they'll get a goodie bag, too, compliments of the Archibald Parks and Recreation.
Well, that sounds like a great thing to have and a great way to get things ready for the season. And I think one of the other things that the Parade of Lights does is it reminds us that there's a lot of local companies and a lot of good companies here to do business with, and that probably works really well during the Christmas season.
That's right. And the Chamber, we promote shopping locally all year round, but we definitely want you to take note that this Saturday, November 29th, tomorrow, is Small Business Saturday. So this is a national campaign to encourage people to shop locally.
All right. Well, I'm sure there'll be doors open and people ready to greet you, and we'll be looking forward to that. So we're not very far away from the start of the Parade of Lights here in Archbold, and we're looking forward to this and hope you are too. Julie, while we're waiting for the parade to get our way, I know that a parade with this many things going on, like a race and the parade and the Festival of Lights, you need a lot of volunteers to make all this happen.
That's right. Just for the parade and the race in itself, we have probably 35 volunteers out there on the route, you know, guarding the intersections. And then the Festival of Lights, it takes a lot of volunteers to set up the festival, as well as our street department and our parks and recs. It just takes a lot of effort, and we're so fortunate to live in a community that people are so willing to help and donate, too. The Festival of Lights, we spend between $3,000 and $5,000 a year on light bulbs, just on light bulbs. And so our community contributes to that through fundraisers and just personal donations.
What kind of fundraisers do you have for the Festival of Lights?
The Celebrity Wait Staff is very popular. We hold that at the Blue, where we have some of our celebrity people from town, from every walk of life, that wait on tables, and we just make money off the tips. We get all the tips for the Festival of Lights, and generally that raises around $4,000.
That's great. Great support here in Archbold for that. And we're not very far away from the start, as I understand. We've got some folks coming down Stryker Street. So after they come from Stryker Street, they come up here on Defiance Street. Where do they go?
Then they will turn north on Walnut, then back to, west on Walnut to LaJoy, and back to Conagra.
Where it all starts. Well, I understand there were a lot of cars in the parking lot there, so we have a good number of units this year?
I'm thinking around 45.
That's great. That's wonderful. We'll have a great parade here tonight. Looking forward to it here in Archbold. Well, we've seen the police make the turn on to Defiance Street from Stryker Street. They're coming up north here, and we're about ready to see all the entries in our Parade of Lights here as they pass by us here in front of the Village Hall. You can hear the band playing in the background. Santa Claus is coming to town. Everybody's all excited. No doubt about that. Well, we have the police leading us off here, Julie, and that's kind of special for us tonight, isn't it?
This is a very special night. Our Grand Marshals, our Police Chief Martin Schmidt, and this is his last official job of his career as our police chief. He retires tonight, so congratulations, Martin Schmidt. And also riding with Martin is Mayor Jim Wise. Martin, thank you for your many service years.
Thank you. We appreciate that. Right behind them, we've got the Archbold American Legion Post, BLW 311, leading the way, and they have every year. Post BLW 311 was formed in 1919. American Legion, Legion Auxiliary, and Sons of the American Legion are all a part of it, and they say thank you, Archbold. This is the Archbold Marching Band under the direction of Beth Ball. They were recently featured on 13ABC for the use of an iPad application to learn of their marching drill. The band gives over 36 performances a year. This is the Archbold Marching Band. And right behind the Archbold Marching Band, we've got some law enforcement here represented in the parade here. The Archbold Police Department, of course, leading off here. And followed by the Wauseon Police Department. Fulton County Sheriff's Department, Sheriff Roy Miller wants to wish everyone a safe and happy holiday and wants to thank everyone for their support and continues to proudly serve the citizens of Fulton County. Next, we have the Swanton Police Department represented here in the parade and the Fayette Police Department. And they remind you a very important message, particularly during the holiday season, is to drive sober or get pulled over. So you don't want to have that happen. And of course, everybody's nice and safe and sound when you do.
Our next entry is the Rotary Club, and they are hosting Barb Rittenreicher, who is our celebrity waitress of the year. She raised the most fund for the Festival of Light. And our beloved mascot, Cornelius the Carp, Archibald's mascot, Barb Rittenreicher and Cornelius, and thank you, Archbold Rotary, celebrating 61 years in Archbold with 60 members.
We have the Stryker Choir back in the parade here. I think this is their sixth year that they've been in the parade, something like that. Let's listen to them sing. Right behind them, have we ever got a decorated fire truck? This is the Archbold Department's 101 aerial truck. And look at the way they've got that tower decorated up, the reindeer all up there. And they're making sure, they're making sure the chimney isn't smoking too badly, Julie. And right behind them, they've got their gator. They have 39 dedicated men and women on the department. Volunteers at Archbold, congratulations to all of them. And what a great decoration job they've done this year for the Parade of Lights here. Now that sounds like a fire truck here coming up. We've got Nofsinger Door Sales. In addition to garage doors, Nofsinger Door Sales offers and installs any kind of entry door and windows. More from the Archbold Fire Department here. Got some kids up there saying hi to everybody, and they thank our troops as well coming through the parade. Here we go. Here's Nofsinger Door Sales. Just jump the gun a little bit. In addition to garage doors, they offer and install any kind of entry door and windows, and they say happy holidays from Nofsinger Door Sales. I heard a fire engine. I wasn't wrong, Julie. That's coming up right here. The Wauseon Fire Department is here tonight. They have a 100-foot aerial tower truck starting through, and of course their parade's tomorrow night, so it's always nice to have them come. But look at the decoration job that they have done. And there's Ronald McDonald up there. Hello, Ronald!
Happy holidays!
Happy holidays to you too. Good to see you. We got celebrities here. Aside from the aerial truck, we've got the Humvee right behind them, a 1993 Humvee. Cassidy Wells, the 2014 Miss Swaseon, daughter of David and Ellie Wells, currently a freshman at BGSU. 28 members on the Swaseon department. They make 1,200 runs a year. Harvey Bach with us. Hello, Harvey. Harvey and a great niece, Renee Bach. And the horse's name is Snapshot. Now here's somebody who has combined equipment and lights. Oh, that's awful. Archbold Equipment, your hometown Case International Harvester dealership, providing product, service, and support for 50 years. Archbold Equipment there. Got a nice bobcat there that goes along.
What?
We still have some fire departments coming in. That's more fire departments this year, Julie. The Gorham Fayette Fire Department. This is ladder truck number 302. And they're decorated up. I mean, fire department trucks always have flashing lights, but they've added other colored lights for the parade of lights here as well. They have a part-time fire chief and 35 volunteer firefighters. The chief is Robert Stillion Jr. Gorham Fayette Fire Department. They've got their brush truck number 304 here. Got their generator going, so we've got lots of lights and really decorated up nicely. Got another ladder truck here, engine tanker. This is ladder truck 307. There you go. And they also have a medic unit as well. So thank you to Gorham Fayette Fire Department for being here tonight. That's really nice. Shadell Farm Drainage. This is the first time that they have been in the Parade of Lights, and what a job they have done. 1929 tile drainage trencher is being shown here. They're based out of Lyons. They serve local farms. Shadell Farm Drainage, and great job. First time in the parade. Still have some more camaraderie among fire departments. This is Brady Township Fire Department. And some future firefighters up there too, decorating their truck. Very nice. Balzer Incorporated, this is a full-scale Christmas train. This is also their first year in the parade, and a great job too. They do industrial painting of components for high volume manufacturing companies. And what a nice job. Got a Christmas train in the, even with smoke coming out of the smokestack. That's terrific. Souder Village wants to remind you that they've got holiday lantern tours throughout December. They're open for holiday shopping, and the shops are open year-round, of course. You can enjoy dinner at the barn. Everybody does that. They love that. And treats at the Dough Box Bakery and a relaxing stay at the Heritage Inn as well. That's Souder Village.
I was trying to call you guys. We're
Brooks Reeker and the grandkids.
Get on the float. Get on the float.
And they're having a great time. They have shepherds going to the manger. A great scene here. And they're grabbing all their family and saying, come on, let's go. They're going to Bethlehem. There they are. Now we're talking about the parade of lights. We've got some electric vehicles and they're lit up here. This is EV Motorsports with Northwest State Community College. They took second place at the winning electric vehicle cart. Northwest State Community College's pit crew follows around with them, the student club that designs and races competition electric vehicles. And if you don't believe they can go fast, they can go plenty fast. Life Connection of Ohio. Tanya Gomez received a double lung transplant in 2004. This entry is celebrating the gift of life, and those walking include living donors, donor families, and transplant recipients. This is the third year they've been in our parade here, the Life Connection of Ohio. Granite Industries is here. This is the first time they've been in the parade. This is wonderful. They're the manufacturer of scaffolding, bleachers, staging, and carts. They're showing some of those and doing some nice lights, very nice entries. These are great. This is one of the things we've heard so much about. The Ohio Department of Transportation got local groups to decorate their plows, and what a great job they did this year with all the plows around the area. And this is one of the units that they decorated the plow with. What a sharp idea. Buckeye Concrete Coatings has our next entry. They specialize in decorative overlays for garage floors, patios, offices, and factories. They have alternative flooring solutions for every need. And for more information, you can visit them at buckeyecoating.com on the internet. Buckeye Concrete Coatings. Isn't that neat? St. James Lutheran Preschool has the next entry. They're a Christ-centered preschool. They have a live nativity here with their students and alumni. They're located in Burlington. They have a 3-year-old class and 4- to 5-year-old classes as well at St. James Lutheran Preschool. And we'll remind you, you can watch all of this on TV 26 during the Christmas season. So not only can you enjoy it tonight, you can enjoy it with your family and friends through the season. Archbold Refuge Service, proud to announce Santa's favorite reindeer is Trasher. I love it. This new compressed natural gas powered truck reduces emissions and uses domestic fuel resources. Your local company, a proud supporter of the Archbold community. I can't get over that. Trasher, on Trasher. Oh, I love it. Complete Wireless Solutions. Is it been in the parade a good number of years, and they're back with us again. They have Complete Wireless Solutions. They're your local Verizon Wireless Premium Agent. Consider us not only for your wireless needs, they say, but also for a home phone, home internet, Dish Network, and Time Warner services, and in-house repairs for your broken electronics. Complete Wireless Solutions. This is Risen Enterprises, a family-owned and operated sign shop in Archbold. They have custom signage locally and nationally. They have the flexibility to respond timely. They're efficient and economic. Ryzen Enterprises. And they say, this will be a sign to you. You will find a baby born in a manger. Luke 2:12. Heartland Energy USA, they're all lit up here tonight. They're located south of Stryker on Route 191. They're owned and operated by the Sloans. There's Vernon in there. Hello, Vernon. They offer Heatmaster outdoor wood furnaces, Bad Boy mowers, the all-new American-made Intimidator UTVs, and Green Mountain wood pellet grills. Heartland Energy would like to wish everyone a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. And we could use the wood stove right about now anyway. We always have a good time. It's outdoors and gets us ready for the Christmas season, and we're certainly getting that tonight. Nice job. You can tell a lot of people took a lot of time this year decorating their vehicle.
I'm really pleased because not only do we have a lot of new entries, but people have really taken a lot of effort and making them very good this year.
Now, speaking of first-time entries, the Neil Giffey family, this is their first time in the parade. The Giffey family Buckeye Christmas. You can maybe hear a little Buckeye music in the background. They have a horseless carriage replica that was hand-built by Gene Giffey in Archbold last winter. The carriage was brought to Ohio for the summer parade season. Scarlet and gray sleigh, all for us. And that looks really sharp. They've done a nice job doing that. We have some scouts coming up next. Boy Scout Pack 263, Cub Scout Pack 263. They've been weaving lifetime values since 1910. They offer educational activities designed to help families teach how they make good decisions throughout their lives. And SAD Transportation, who's helping them, out of Wauseon, owned by Sean and Kim Netcher. Thank you, guys. Look at them all up there. Yeah. Smile real big. What do we got coming up, Julie? Look at this.
This is Toothless from How to Train Your Dragon 2.
Oh, I should have known it's Toothless. This is the first year in the parade from Frucci's Health and Wellness. Velda, Stoic, and Ashton are walking. They're located in Napoleon. Everything you need for a healthy lifestyle in one place. I don't know that Toothless comes visit you, but I'll bet you can find a lot of things there to help you with your life. Frucci's.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Merry Christmas. A lot of Merry Christmas going on. Well, looky here, we've got Terry Hendricks, Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, Ram. They're here again, all lit up with a nice vehicle, and they're reminding you to see them during the Christmas season as well. Oh, look, we've got the Farmers and Merchants State Bank here with their fire truck. They've been serving Northwest Ohio and Northeast Indiana for a long time. 117 years for the local community, for the Farmers and Merchants State Bank. That's a 1935 antique fire truck. They make local decisions, always be your community bank. Look at car one here. We've got a, what do you call that? A snow bus? Snow van? It's a snowman van. A snowman van, I like that. From car one, fourth generation family run business. Automobile dealership in Archbold. More than eight decades, they provided clean, dependable automobiles, celebrating 90 years of business. Wayne Newman is back with us. Wayne, how are you? Keeping warm up there? Wayne Newman always has a display, and I think he's made every parade of light.
1957 Model 620 John Deere tractor.
Very good. We always look forward to seeing Wayne. All right, what do we got?
Looky here, it's Jeff the Schwann's man.
All right, just what we need, some ice cream tonight. Well, they have plenty of other things too. Schwann's Home Service, established in 1952 by Marvin Schwann, driven by Jeff the Schwann's man. Jeff's been serving Archbold and the surrounding communities for 13 years now, delivering top quality frozen foods directly to your door. All right. We've got St. John's Christian Preschool. They're singing Shine for Jesus on there. St. John's Christian Preschool, one of the oldest preschools in Archbold. They serve 56 children. That's their highest enrollment ever. St. John's Christian Preschool. And for the Parade of Lights, they're shining for Jesus. One of the folks who've always helped out with the Festival of Lights and the Parade of Lights has been D&G Welding and that big Peace on Earth sign that they have across there. I kind of look forward to that, seeing that every year. It just becomes a tradition. They've been in business since 1980. They love to fix and repair. And Dan, Julie, Luke, Neil, Jesse, and Tim say thank you for your business. Hope I remembered everybody there. But that's great. They always do a nice job for everybody. Well, not only does everybody get to park in their parking lot, but ConAgra Foods has an entry in the parade this year. This is their frozen theme. How appropriate. ConAgra, formerly LaJoy, was founded in 1922, They have things such as Healthy Choice, Banquet, Chef Boyardee, Swiss Miss, Hunts, and Marie Callender. Nice entry from ConAgra, thank you. And that looks like a Marco. Is it a Marco from Marco's Pizza? How you doing, Marco? Locally owned and operated for over 20 years. Call tonight for a double delicious deal. Merry Christmas from Chef Marco and the Archbold helpers going through. Christie Motor Sales. Got Chevy, Buick, Chevy trucks, whatever you need there. Got a nice Tahoe on the back there. How about that gets through snow pretty nicely? And they can take care of you here at Christie Motors. Nice that they've got a whole showroom full of folks who can watch the parade inside. They do that for a lot of folks every year. Salon Bliss. They've got the Grinch who stole Christmas, but making sure everybody looks good while he does it. They got the salon, spray tanning, gel nails at Salon Bliss. We've got somebody going to extremes. Extreme Automotive Detailing. No job's too big, no job too small. They do detailing, remote car starters, truck accessories, and more from Extreme Automotive Detailing. And they made sure that they took care of the details of lights to show some of their work here. Pretty sharp. Here comes Ken Rivenaugh and his farm all here. He's an avid tractor lover, sharing his 1964 806 International Farm All tractor. Sixth year in the parade. Thank you, Ken. In the new old-fashioned way. Fry and Sons, Realty and Auctioneers. coming through the parade. They've been in the auction business since 1963. Known throughout the United States as a high-quality, full-service auction firm. Fry & Sons Realty and Auctioneers, rocking around the Christmas tree. Teresa Taylor's Grooming Salon, Dog Grooming Salon, Doggy Daycare and Boarding. It's all about the doggies. They never turn the light off and go home. Teresa Taylor's Grooming and Shannon too. I didn't want to forget Shannon. No, no, that would be bad. I won't forget Shannon. Rough Furniture and Carpet, full line furniture and floor covering store. They have merchandise for every room, celebrating 106 years. It's on sale when you're ready to buy, they say. They have home furnishings and accessories to fit your need and a range of prices to fit every budget. They got a lot of folks up there. I don't know how they chose who got to sit in the recliner, but I'll bet it was an interesting selection, don't you, Julie? All right, we've got Luckville Supply Center, their local hardware lumber store since 1962. They're a do-it-best store. They've got a live nativity here. Merry Christmas, they say, from all the employees at Luckville's Supply Center. I don't know. I think they've been in every one of the parades. They're a big supporter of the Parade of Lights here. Look at this. Souder Woodworking Company, the leading manufacturer ready to assemble furniture in North America. Third generation privately held family run business started right here in Archbold. Toys, these are toys from 1934-ish to 2014. Souder wishes you all a Merry Christmas. Platinum membership plus member, Souder Woodworking Company. Lots of great toys and plenty of girls and boys who love those. Julie, we've had a wonderful parade here this year. Plenty of new folks and lots of lights all lit up on the parade. This is a great way to start it all off.
Thank you everybody for coming, and thank you everybody that participated in both the run and the parade. Now let's go to the pavilion and see Santa Claus.
And of course the Festival of Lights starts tonight, and that runs through the 1st of January.
Right, and it's lit from 4 until 11 every day.
So folks can come through and see, and it's free. So make your way to Archbold and enjoy the Ruley Park Festival of Lights all through the Christmas season, and make sure you stop in and see some of the folks who had floats here and some of the merchants, and shop locally too.
Right, shop, dine, and discover Archbold.
All right, sounds like a good plan. Julie Brink from the Archbold Chamber, thank you for doing this. It was always a good time, and we've had this, and make sure you enjoy this on TV 26 through the Christmas season. I'm Bill Priest. Have a nice night and a Merry Christmas.